Joshua Clottey, former IBF welterweight champion of the world, you know. He just finished training at the Atokwashi gym here in Accra where he trains. Champ, welcome.
Thank you.
And we see that you are training. We remember when you fought the last time in March, you said something about retirement. So why the training, or we are still on the comeback trail?
Well, I said that, but it was because of the media. That's why I said I'm expecting them to tell me that it's not right for me to retire. But yes, I haven't heard anything. So anybody asks me, I just say what I believe is okay for me. I'll fight again.
I see. So any plans about when you fight again? Do you have an opponent pencil down yet?
Well, I have a couple of guys that are working with me. You know my promoter, right? I don't like the way he wanted to treat my contract. So we're still hanging on there talking about it.
Oh, is this your promoter? And you still have a contract with him? Okay.
I wanted him to win a couple of Ghana fighters because he promoted a lot of fights in New York. Yeah. So very soon people will hear what I'm going to fight.
I see. And is it going to be in Ghana? Will you see you fight in Ghana again, or you are just going to go straight to the United States?
Well, if you ask me, you make it feel like people are there that you want you to lose. So you gotta
Okay, so we heard you in the news recently, less than 2 weeks ago, that you were wanted by the police. You are beating a certain boy who has played football. What actually happened? Happened on the football field.
Yeah,
you know.
I normally always after like gym.
About.
No, I went to the police station and arrived at the station. The other thing that police was to arrest me. Police, like you said, sometimes police can arrest me. It depends on how this is. But if you are okay, you know how to talk to them, they normally come down for you to explain yourself. So I think, nothing like that, police never looking after me, police never wanted me.
Okay, and let's talk a bit about kind of boxing. What's happening? You see some boxers go out there and lose and come, and you know, all that. But your old friend, Joseph Kikon Agbeko, he has risen to number one in the WBO bantamweight ratings. There is also Emmanuel Gamboitego, who is also number one in the WBO lightweight ratings. What do you think about these two guys? Should they take an immediate, if they get the chance, they should just go and compete for the world title straight ahead, or you think they should relax a bit?
As for Game Boy, the time is running against him. And as for Joseph, he is doing pretty well, because we already know he's a man to the field, to the top of the boxing game. So now, Joseph Agogo is doing very, very well because of his age. He's doing fantastic, man. If he get a chance to fight for a world title, should grab it. But as for the Game Boy is supposed to be there by now. Where he is now, to me, he's too behind. You know, he's too behind. Game Boy is not there before Richie Kumbi came into the scene. But he's now a champion. Sometimes if you late, doesn't mean
you're
done. You still can do it. You still have a bright future. You know, there are a couple of guys that they are doing well.
I see. Then talking about the amateurs, there was news recently that they are camping, no money support from government. You know, what do you think we have to do to really make government put money into boxing as they do, let's say, football?
You know, the whole thing looks like a politics thing. One thing that I wanted to say, I normally don't talk about this kind of issues because it's none of my business. But so far as you ask me, let me first out a little bit. You know, one thing about this whole thing is like politics, you know. When the blacks are going to be to buy, he said, let's invite them to
for him now. Can he return?
I think this Isaac Dobby thing, you two, you are part of it. You and his father. Because he said, I keep saying, they're making the boy exceptional. He's just a normal guy. We are full of this. I remember they used to talk about me, whether I'm going to go to the
exceptional.
the same time, he's an attacking fighter. I keep saying, if he had a defensive game,
us already about possibly fighting again. People are mentioning the guys that we know you were supposed to fight in Canelo, and now we all know that it didn't happen. You say he chickened out. There's all of Golovkin out there, and some of the guys in the welterweight and the super welterweight division where you fight now. You know, who is your eye on that possibly you are ready for them right now? champ, and we wish you the best of luck.